We're back and you're watching News Channel 3 Live at 9. Imagine sitting down to dinner with people from all walks of life with different political viewpoints and having a real conversation.
No food fights involved now. Instead, it's a chance for Memphis residents to have serious discussions, respectful discussions about the city, the country, and the world around us. Here to explain more about the Soapbox Dinner put on by the League of Women Voters, Carolyn Michael Banks and Anna Smith. Good to have you.
Good morning,
pleasure
ladies.
Being here.
Thank you for having us.
This could get rocky. If you look at Facebook, there's so much acrimony and other social media outlets. There's so much acrimony. You've done this for years. What is the atmosphere usually?
I went for the first time last year as a participant, and the table where I sat was about the Nathan Bedford Forrest removal of the statue.
That's certainly a hot topic.
Yes. And interesting to your point about how things happen in Facebook, I think having people face to face, it's different. Mm-hmm.
So what was the tone of that conversation? Were people still open? Were people still respectful of others? What was the engagement like?
It was a very safe place. And I don't know how they created that atmosphere.
Yeah.
But it felt like at my table that everybody felt they had a voice.
And people were willing to listen at least, whether they agreed or not.
Yes, yes. And I think the fact that the facilitators they chose really set the tone. Mm-hmm. So the table where I sat, attorney Van Turner, how perfect to be at the table for that discussion.
Right, but he was very much on one side of that issue as he spearheaded the effort.
Yes, he did.
So,
but I think he was able to, with his understanding of the entire issue in depth, as many of us were not as close to it, he was able to lend something to the conversation.
So to each table, do you tackle a different topic, or how does this essentially work, and why do it this way?
That's right. There are 12 tables, and there are different topics for each. So you can choose one that is maybe something you feel really passionate about or something you want to be educated on and you want to hear multiple sides of the story. Last year, I was on the gun rights table, which, again,
another
you can imagine.
Very hot topic.
Very hot topic. But just like Carolyn said, we were discussing earlier, it really was a safe space. There was ample time for people of different views to say what they wanted without feeling attacked. And I do think taking it off social media, bringing it in person to person, really made a difference.
I wonder if the league can do this like every month because it's something that needs to happen.
Yes.
Yeah, what's the diversity like? I was there as well last year, so I know the answer to that question, but that's important because different genders, we hear League of Women Voters, we think it's all female, not at all.
Right.
Different ages, different ethnicities.
Well, the League of Women Voters was started 100 years ago. We're celebrating that this year. But in the 1970s, we opened it up to have men join us because really we're just an advocacy group for voting rights.
And nonpartisan, we
should say. Nonpartisan, which in this day and age is kind of hard to come by. But yes, the dinner is definitely inclusive. There were probably more men at my table than there were women speaking about gun rights last year.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
What did you feel the takeaway was when you actually left the table? Did you feel even more of a sense of empowerment? Did you feel that your voice was able to be heard? Or what was the feeling like?
I feel empowered anyway.
Right.
But I think the fact that those who were sitting at our table felt, as I mentioned, had a chance to be heard. I don't think people's ideas may have changed, but I think being able to hear someone outside of the normal circle where you sit was an important time for people to have. Because often we tend to stay in our bubbles.
Yes.
And we don't really have conversations with other people. And that was a platform for that to happen.
We kind of, as humans, like the echo chamber because it makes us feel good about ourselves.
Are there any topics you will shy away from, though, especially for something like this? You guys seem to be so very open and you put it right there on the table, so to speak. Is there anything that you won't discuss there?
I don't believe so. Every time they organize, the league organizes one of these dinners, there's a table discussion of what should we talk about, and hot topics are certainly not off the table because, like Carolyn said, this is a safe space where people can voice their opinions, and shouldn't we be having some civic discourse?
What are some of the topics this year? Because they are national as gun rights, and they are very local as with the statues.
Right. Well, the table that I'm attending this year, that I'll be sitting with you, one of our facilitators, is talking about fake news and how large media organizations are maybe contributing to that, or are they contributing to that, and you know, what is your opinion on that? Carolyn, you want to share the table that you're going to
join? I'll be sitting in terms of women and empowerment and the role that we've played. So I'm psyched about this year.
All right, the topics are hot once again.
Next Tuesday, there is
still
room.
Absolutely.
And it all helps to support the league and its work.